Well, hello folks, and welcome to part 8. And I thought I'd start here because there's some weird, like, random poster stuff going on the right over here, which I thought was interesting. And I have no idea why it's doing that. But anyway, part 8, here we go. Last time we defused some bombs, and this time we are going to be going back to the security room to do something. I'm assuming it'll have more to do with Carlito and the whole Isabella storyline thing. So the time now is almost 5. An Otis will call. There we go. So we're going to check on Jesse, the DHS agent. We can actually get into this goddamn room. There we go. Actually, I don't think I've been outside or like up here with this kind of lighting, so that's kind of cool. And I thought, because I haven't really shown it off yet, I'd show you the outside of the mall. Which, just look at the contrast of colour between the floor texture and them zombies. And look over here, like this, actually it doesn't look that bad now, but like earlier I was looking at it and it was like yellow and it just looks like disgusting. It's like the like lowest quality texture they could have chose for the floor. But anyway, let's go and see Jessie, see what she wants.
As soon as Brad gets his hands on that terrorist, I guess it'll be case closed, huh?
No. You know of anything else he could be planning?
No. Nothing but the bombs. He's got his computer hidden away. I'm sure there's plenty of information on it.
Can you take me there? To his hideout?
Leave it to me.
Okay, cool, we get 4 parts to this one. I'm used to the last one as being like 1 or 2. Continue. Okay, cool, so this one should be eventful. Where is she? Okay. Oh, there you go.
Anyone there?
So... Alright, okay, cool. Hopefully she won't be too awkward to... escort. But she could be quicker. So yeah, this is the little hideout room. If you watched one part earlier where we had went to Cletus's gun shop, her room is like right next to that, like in the ceiling above some boxes. She's gonna take forever. I don't even have any other like kind of better weapons. Come on then. So yeah, today's like really nice day outside. It's like sunny. I'm in a good mood for once, which is rare. So yeah, hopefully this is just go really good. Oh yeah, and the other thing is you can tell which one has the queen because of them like doing that like animation thing. So that's fun fact for you, and that will come into play later on when we're doing overtime mode, which shouldn't be too far away at this point. See, there are 18 hours of game time left until the helicopter man is meant to return. So we'll see how well that goes. If she'll hurry up. She's probably going to take so long that I can actually, like, get another katana off the roof. Hopefully she'll actually move when I clear them out. But we'll see. Game is very temperamental sometimes. Careful, almost went too far. Where is... Okay, cool. Good job. Yeah, she's just like off. So from here, yeah, we have to go into the North Plaza, I think it is. Yeah. And I could use the skateboard, but there's no point, because I'm just going to have to wait for her either way. Unless I can give her one, I'm doubtful. God, this is getting really dark. Let's keep going. Okay, good, good, good. Keep going, keep going. She has so much room. Oh yeah, one thing I do quite like is how the like blood actually gets on his clothes. Yeah. Like, I mean, it's gone now, but considering it's like a game that's like super old, it's kind of impressive actually. So yeah, while I'm recording this, it's E3 going on. We just had... Xbox was yesterday, and the only real thing of note for me is Keanu Reeves in Cyberpunk 2077, which is pretty cool. He's just like one of my favorite people, man. And judging from the reaction you got, I think he's most people's, like, he's just like an awesome dude. Like, you just want to like hang out with him. He seems like super chill. And other than that was the Project Scarlet coming out at the end of the next year. Which makes sense, because it'll be 7 years, and the 360 had about, was it 8 years? 7 or 8 years? Because Dead Rising 3 was a day one exclusive for the Xbox One. So a good tie-in. Dead Rising 3 I thought was pretty great, to be honest. Like, I think people don't like it so much, but I think it's really good. Like, it's fun, it doesn't have the... Like, because this game was really hard, like, the first time I played it. But like, when you know what you're doing, and you have like the OP weapons, then it's... really couldn't be any simpler. Come on, man. Oh, that's good. Yeah, and then plus in 3 you get callbacks to the other games. Like, what's not to like? I heard a complaint that Nick Ramos is too concerned, like his face looks too worried a lot of the times. And I'm like, he's dealing with the zombie apocalypse, like, of course he's gonna be like scared. Like, that's what I liked about it. Like, Frank kind of seems concerned, but not too much. And then Chuck's just like many like a badass, like, kind of biker dude. So it makes sense for there to be like a actual kind of human person is gonna respond to people getting eaten in front of him. So I always liked 3. And here we go. Yeah, so this is the upstairs ceiling den. We're about to see. Where we basically stay until like the final boss. I'd say basically we do stay there until the final boss. So yeah, not much to see, just like a few kind of catwalk kind of things. Alright, this just kind of reminds me of like a James Bond kind of thing. This is totally like this would make a cool like set piece. And actually, I don't think I've used that exit before. Where does that take you out? Oh, it does. North Pass. I might just take you out further along. Okay, yeah, so she's up here with her laptop. And she basically just like stays like that for the rest of it. I think we get some major plot details here, so I'll just stay quiet.
It's no good. It's password protected. I'll try words we both might know. Family stuff, things like that.
I like the thinking animation.
What's this cable?
It looks like part of a jamming device. I won't be able to disable it unless I log in.
I don't want to know where he's hiding that.
I found something interesting on a security feed from inside a store. Could you come back here? I need you to check it out.
All right. I'm headed back now.
They treat me like a yo-yo. Okay, I guess we don't get any information and stuff. So now we're going to Jesse. And I actually don't remember what this is going to be. So I guess we'll find out together. Is there like another crappy weapon? I don't want to use up my chainsaws, because I'm going to need them for the stuff later. 2x4, that'll do. The animation for it is so weird. It's like... Look at that. Actually, I should probably have drank something. Didn't realize how badly I... Whoa! Yeah! Cool. Didn't realize how badly I was doing. Okay. And then today... Well, it was last night, but I just got around to watching the Bethesda conference thing today. And... Basically, for me, the big takeaway was a release date for Doom, which is November the 22nd. That game, I'll be honest, was kind of like the original. The 2016 one, you know what I mean? That game for me was like hit and miss. Like, I did enjoy it, but it had to be in... it kind of bursts, because it, for me, it was quite repetitive. One of the, like, great memories I have is, because it was repetitive, and I was like, well, it's basically like the kind of same thing all the time. Me and my brother played it last summer, and of course, last summer was the World Cup, so it would just be like, me and him, we'd every time someone died, we'd like swap over. And so you can choose to give them stuff, or you can choose to not give them stuff. And I think sometimes it goes badly, and sometimes it goes all right. So I don't know, because. Oh, I thought one of the policemen might have had a handgun. I don't have one, and I'm not sure where I'd pick one up anyway. So I'm just going to go and do this Jesse thing. Anyway, as I was saying, last year we had the World Cup, and obviously England got to the semi-final. But that was just like a great time, like watching, like playing Doom with my brother. It was like sunny, just finished college. Like that was just like a really good time to look back on. So like when I was playing it, we'd swap when each other died. And so in the meantime, I just have like the matches on the laptop while he was playing it. 3 matches a day. I love that.
Take a look
at
this.
Oh my god.
The guy being dragged? I think it's Carlito.
You could be right. Where is this?
The basement of the North Plaza, right in front of the butcher shop.
So yeah, the butcher, this was the bane of my existence when I was 12, playing it the first time. Because I'd ran low on time, and I didn't have any like good weapons, and I was probably still like a lower level, so he's slower and he hasn't got as many like good moves, and basically it was just a disaster, and it would stress me out, and I was scared of the game still at that point for some reason. Like it's like the least scary game ever. Well, not the least scary. I mean, Viva Pinata. It's probably more scary than, but yeah, I used to hate this so much, and actually I haven't played it fully this far through again since, I don't think, other than like maybe like once, and that would have been like a good long time ago. So I'm gonna go get, I want to fight him like as not unfairly as possible. So I'm hoping my mega awesome like jumping somersault kick will do a good job. So I'll take the katana and the submachine gun. And what should I ditch? I can probably get rid of like a skateboard. Wow, I'm surprised I got actually over that. Well, and there you go. Okay, that was a massive waste of time then. So yeah, it's like Jerry or Larry, I can't remember. But this, I literally had to be like 50 times. I just kept trying this mission to no avail. Probably shouldn't have jumped there. Never mind. So yeah, katana and the gun, and then I can try the jump kick if I need to. Great big burger. So I think we're going back to the maintenance tunnels. Although she said that it's in the basement of the North Plaza. But I'm pretty sure it's not, so. Like, where's that arrow pointing to? Hang on. So I need to go somewhere where I can wait for the scroll thing to go across, but there's too many zombies. The butcher goal meat processing area maintenance tunnel. See, I told you. Why is it... The arrow sucks, okay? That's my advice. Do not pay attention to the arrow, because the arrow doesn't know what's going on either. The arrow is as useless as the AI. I'm not saying a lot. When it comes to the maintenance tunnels, at least. I mean, sometimes it's alright, but... Alright, okay, we might actually finally get to play with the car in the tunnel this time. Because hopefully that barricade's moved, and it is. Okay, that's good, and it's left. Tight corner, a pro. And then double doors there is where you want to be. Okay, next one should do it, and out. There we go. And I'll get ready with the Uzi, I think it's called. And here we go, meat processing plant. With the butcher.
Ah, a customer.
That guy over there. That meat.
Oh, this is good meat, huh? I just got it in here. It's fresh. You just wait right there, sir. In a moment, you can try the best ground meat you've ever tasted.
Whoa, ground? Wait a minute, listen. I had something else in mind.
Zombies! No good. I can't serve my customers spoiled meat like that. I have a reputation to uphold. Trust me, I'm a butcher. I've got the best meat in town.
Trust me, I'm a butcher is one of my favorite quotes. So yeah, so should we go for the thingy first? Let's go. Is this actually going well? Come on, come on. How in the hell could I not do that when I was younger? How?
You're finished. It's over.
What about Isabella?
She's on our side now. She's checking out your computer right now.
My purpose in life has been to get revenge for what you people did to Santa Cabeza, to my hometown. Why? Why was your meat so much more important to you than human life? Why? Why did my people have to die to feed your fat bellies?
That doesn't excuse what you've done. But I promise, the Santa Cabeza story will be told. But I need the password. Hey! Stay with me! Give me the computer's password!
Hey, aren't zombies great? I mean, all they do is eat and eat and eat, growing in number, just like you good red, white, and blue Americans.
And there you have it. So next one at 10, and right now 8:05. So yeah. So that was, oh, there's a
fantastic.
So yeah, one thing that's impressive that I noticed in the cutscenes, look at how they did his like see-through sweaty top. Now, that's quite impressive. And I wonder what that key's for, unless it's just for this room. But like, I love the animated nipples. Like, that's very impressive. So yeah, there's actually, like, if it goes longer, there's actually like a time limit. And Collier kind of like goes along and then he gets dropped into the meat grinder. But it didn't even last that long, so it doesn't really matter. But yeah, so the katana, very effective against old Larry. Let's see if there's anything in here. Another skateboard, cool. Actually, I should probably drink my juice. So yeah, we're nearly done, guys. Need to make it to 12 noon tomorrow. Yeah, so just need to go to Isabella's, well, Colio's. And I think the password's like Pachamama. That makes sense, considering he keeps saying it. But we'll see. I'm probably wrong. And the car's missing, but it's all right because we have a we have the milk. Is it milk? Whatever the Michelle Club is. Actually, hang on. I want to see what's through here. I don't think I've been this way. Oh, okay. A lot of zombies. Come on. I need the maintenance tunnel key. I wonder if we can still find Brad. Well, that was not worth it. And I'm surprised we didn't lose any health there, but... okay. So I'm gonna go along. That's kind of cool how they like crowd around the car. Or van. I'm gonna go along to where Brad got left. I highly doubt anything still happened. Just to see if he's there. Which I doubt. I think it's first left. Yeah, you can see this is a room where, like, Collio, like, spinning heel kicked him out the door. Yeah, I don't really know where the maintenance key comes into it. Like, I don't remember. Oh, there you go. Okay. Like, I thought we might have to, like, get it off of Brad. But apparently we don't. Okay, so now I'm excited to see what is in that upstairs roomy bit. Because hopefully the van will last that long. Me smashing it off the walls like this ain't gonna help. Or driving through them. Very farmable gas canisters. So yeah, that's the end of it for Colito. So, sucks to be him. Whoa. Alright, okay, let's have a look what's up here then. Where'd all the zombies go? That worked out well. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Supermarket? Ah, okay. I remember there's like another like random door in Alfresca. So I've literally never used any of these like shortcut things before. So that's actually interesting. And there's a bike for no reason. Oh, that was a fail. Oh my god, I cannot control this anymore. Whoa! Whoa! Oh!
Damn it!
Did I blow it up? Oh no, it's still there. I totally thought I'd wrecked it. Oh, okay. Impenetrable. Velvet rope. Look how many there are. That's like crazy. I mean, it's a shame a lot of them are like the same model, but still did a good job with the number count. Oh my gosh, that just literally split apart. Yeah, I'll check it a bit further along where I'm less likely to get mauled. 10 PM. Colito's hideout, North Plaza. Colito is dead. All that's left of him is a locket I need to give to Isabela. And I don't remember this being here either. Where's this leading to? This is exciting. Wow. Wow. Do you see that? Just glitched through everything. Oh. Oh, okay. I didn't know there was.
Yeah.
Like a shortcut. And they've. I've got no idea how this game works. Oh, okay, I guess you can't fit through there. So I guess we'll see what's in Colito's hideout in the next episode. So yeah, join me then for part 9. So thanks a lot for watching, and see you guys next time. Thanks a lot.